and gentlemen, are you ready for some sketch comedy? Oh, I think we can do a bit better than that. Are you ready for some sketch comedy? Then please welcome to the stage the Durham Revue!
Absolutely everyone you could have called back from the dead, you asked for us, the Durham Revue.
I spoke to your grandma up there, and she was quite offended.
We've all been hanging around in the spirit realm for some time now, since we all died before our final show.
Some would say it was a tragedy.
Most wouldn't.
Now, I know you're all thinking, a comedy troupe must have been a pretty hilarious way to die.
Crushed by a massive anvil. All five of us slipping on the same banana peel.
Choked on some silly string?
No, it was just a fire.
A massive house fire.
Burnt to a crisp.
What flavour? Don't worry, we went out chuckling.
We were watching Mrs. Brown's Boys.
The movie.
When the fire happened.
Hey, I'm looking at you, mate, and you look like you don't actually believe that we're ghosts.
We'll get a load of this. Ooh. I bet you feel pretty fucking stupid now.
And like all ghosts, we have some unfinished business.
Title of the show?
We never got to do our final show. Perform it now, and we get our eternal rest.
Actually, I've got a fair bit else I never got round to doing while I was alive.
Yeah, me too, actually. Yeah.
I never got to debut my one-man beatbox show. Beatalicious. Yeah, I'm very good, actually.
I never got to finish watching Mrs. Brown's Boys.
None of us did, and it's a crying shame.
The BBC never commissioned my TV idea. It was going to be a hard-hitting documentary about the housing crisis in the USSR.
What was it called?
The Home Under the Hammer and Sickle?
I think that's more of a Channel 5 show.
Anyway, guys, on with the show!
I never made things right with my mum.
Maybe we should just get on with the show then.
This side of the room, make some noise!
We're the Durham Revue, and for the next hour, we're going to be doing some sketches like this.
Hi, I'd like to withdraw £50, please.
Excuse me?
I'd like to withdraw £50, please.
I'm sorry, what?
I want to withdraw £50.
You're aware that's not how a sperm bank works.
We do in pints.
Ah.
What a mix-up. Here's another one.
So, did you decide whether you were going to bury or cremate your grandfather?
Well, it's been a really tough decision, but I think we'll just let him live.
What a caring granddaughter. How about a political one?
What are you doing back here? I fired you!
There's a glass ceiling for women in this line of work.
There's a glass ceiling for everyone in this line of work.
Dismantle the patriarchy! I will not be fired!
This is why I didn't want you building my conservatory.
Wow, it really is PC gone mad. How about a sad one?
I'm afraid I have some bad news. As I'm sure you're aware, your son was due in for a very delicate operation today.
Oh, God!
I'm so sorry. Little Timmy didn't make it.
No, 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 please, no!
Sorry, I'm late. My taxi got stuck in traffic.
Oh, Timmy, thank you.
Yeah!
Not our best.
How about a cheeky one? Order, order! The defendant has been accused of sleeping with his boss's daughter. I don't see how this is a crime.
I'm self-employed.
Guilty! Cheeky!
That was not cheeky, it was gross.
Welcome to the show!
Notice real hardwood flooring. and the exposed beams. I have to say, the area is also delightful.
Oh, this is lovely.
Yeah, very nice. What was that?
What was what?
What was that sound?
The sound of recently renovated crown moulding.
That's not a sound.
Oh, the sound of potential domestic bliss for you both when you buy this house for me and I get my commission.
The banging and the screaming.
Oh, right. The sound of the lost souls from the ancient burial ground this house was built on.
Yeah, that'll be it.
Oh, very chic. Can I test the tap?
By all means.
The blood just came out of the tap.
Trilling red water.
This place gets chicer by the minute.
Look, be honest with us here. Is this house
haunted by the demonic wave of souls of the damned?
Not what I was going to ask, but I do now want to know if the house is haunted. Yeah.
Just a little bit.
Oh, come on, James. It's only haunted a little bit.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how haunted is a little bit?
27.
What?
That's how many people have been murdered here.
Jesus!
Is that a lot? Because, James, we haven't seen many houses. I'd like to know how that compares.
You know, I think it depends on how you look at it, really.
Yeah, 27 murders in one house is quite a lot.
So you could say this house is unique.
Oh, I suppose you bloody could.
Oh, James, I've always wanted to live in a unique house.
Give me the brochure. It says there's a demon in the basement!
That's David. He's a delight.
There's a portal to the sixth circle of hell in the shag carpeting!
I like to think of it as underfloor heating.
I do love to have warm feet.
And the front door locks automatically if you don't pay your rent. What the hell is this place?
Actually, that one's normal. What?
Yeah, no, I know. A lot of estate agents have them now. It's like this smart lock thing.
It's awful.
Oh, that's awful.
I know, right? I like to talk to corporate about it, but they're always like, oh, we have to think of the bottom line, and who dared disturb the slumber of the immolated one?
So I tend to not.
Do you mind if we mull this over for a second?
Yeah,
thank
enough,
you.
Enough.
I'm keeping free.
Chinese red water. I think we made our decision. What with this house being the only one in our price range that isn't in a complete state of uninhabitable disrepair.
The demon!
Buy this house.
There's black mould in the bathroom.
The writers of Billy Elliot.
But Dad, please!
No, son! You really think someone from round here can start doing that? It's nonsense.
But they say I've got potential! I just need to get out of this town!
What you need is to grow up and learn your father's trade.
But I don't want to be a carpenter like you. I want to be the son of God.
Like the other lads your age, Jesus. Have a normal hobby. A normal hobby like football or boxing or ballet like your father.
But this isn't just a hobby, Dad. It's what I was born to do.
You were born in a carpenting town to a carpenting father. You were born to carpet.
But that's no life.
You know how many carpenting accidents there have been recently? What with King Harry Thatcher closing all the carpentry places? I've been busting my arse with those 50 fences for you to spend on your dancing lessons. And you've been spaffing them away. On what?
Joseph!
God.
Oh, the dad!
You need to let him go, Joseph. I've been teaching Jesus at the How to Be Son of God classes, and he's the best there by far.
No, I won't have it. Being a son of God is for girls! You're staying right here, end of.
Then I'll have to resort to my backup career.
A backup career? Oh, of course there's a backup career. Backup career? Well, this is going to be good. What's this backup career then, eh?
Mining! Take off!
There was a massive queue at Grace. Did I miss anything?
This isn't the sort of job you can just turn up late to.
Oh, come on, I was only 10 minutes. I'll defuse the next one. Hear the bell go! Boom, shake, shake, shake the room! Boom, shake, shake, shake the room!
Boom, shake, shake, shake the room! Hello, your call cannot be taken at the moment, so please leave your message after the tone.
Hi Jane, it's Charlie again. I know you weren't too keen on Homes Under the Hammer and Sickle, but I've got another idea for you guys at the BBC. Hear me out, a 9/11 conspiracy drama hosted by John Cleese. Working title, Faulty Towers. Or, if Basil Brush is interested, call it Boom Boom. Just a thought. Why don't you tell the girl what y'all wanna do? You wanna ooh, ah, 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 ooh. That's right, yo, and I'm in the flow. So pump up the volume along with the tempo. I'm here about the witness protection scheme.
Please take a seat, sir.
Naturally, this conversation will have to be recorded. Interview commencing at 10:07 a.m. conducted by Miss Interviewer.
Hello.
And myself, Mr. In Charge of starting the recordings. I also organise the office party.
And they are metal.
Crazy.
Please say your name for the tape.
Obi-Wan Kenobi.
And so you're in need of some witness protection.
Yeah, I thought it would be best to lie low for a bit after the whole Jedi Order got wiped out in that massive montage sequence.
Well, don't worry. We've got all the paperwork sorted. Just need your signature at the bottom.
Thank you. Hang on, it says you're changing my name to Ben Kenobi.
What's wrong with Ben? Ben's a lovely name.
My big cousin's name is Ben.
His big cousin's name is Ben.
You haven't changed my surname.
Clever, isn't it?
What are people going to think? Oh, where's Obi-Wan Kenobi gone? Oh, why don't we ask the new guy who just moved in? What's his name? Ben Kenobi? Can't be the same bloke.
Look, Mr. Kenobi, we know what we're doing.
Do you remember Michael Pedophile Jackson?
Just got rid of the middle name.
No one suspected a thing.
I'll trust you on the name, but why do you have to send me to Tatooine?
What's wrong with Tatooine?
My big cousin lives on Tatooine.
His big cousin lives on Tatooine.
It's a shithole.
It's gentrifying.
They got rid of the Mos Eisley Cantina.
Yeah, it's now a prick.
I don't know, I'm more of a ZZ's kind of guy.
Look, just hear us out, Mr. Kenobi. Picture yourself.
As a hermit living in a cave.
In a cave.
A hermit.
In a cave.
Or you can be an accountant.
Hermit's great.
Oh, Kevin!
Good afternoon,
Kevin! You ready for your transfer?
Who's Kevin?
We shaved him!
Unrecognizable! Witness the fitness, the competent living. One hope, one quest. Witness the fitness, the competent living. One hope, one quest. Witness the fitness, the competent living. One hope, one quest. Witness the...
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
I'm sorry, but you asked for this, Mr. Sinatra. Ignition.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, babe.
Leslie! Are you ready to go?
Sorry, do I know you?
It's me, Peter. This is classic you. Who else could forget their own wedding day?
I think you've got the wrong person.
Are you getting cold feet? We made a pact, remember? If neither of us were married, we should, you know, put a ring on it.
Oh my god, Peter, my year 7 boyfriend. That was 1971.
Yeah, I know, the year Willy Wonka came out.
It's from Deliotus.
Is that my dad in the limo?
Look, we gotta go. The guests are awaiting.
The guests?
Yeah, the whole of 7B.
Are you crazy?
Is he in love?
That was 50 years ago, Peter. We're not getting married.
Why not? I even got us a Willy Wonka cake.
It's made by authentic, real midgets.
No.
Wait. Don't tell me you're already married.
I mean, I was, but he died a year ago.
So, you're not married then?
I don't have to fill a pact I made in primary school.
But it was a pinky promise!
Oh, who cares about a stupid pinky promise?
Actually, the law does. Pinky promises were still legally binding in the 70s, so...
Oh, what?
Just ask my lawyer. See?
I don't want to do this.
Why not? I even got the old school dinner ladies to do the catering. You wouldn't believe how long it took me to convince the care home staff to let them come.
Well, they surely can't be fit for work.
They're really not. They have the physique of a raisin.
I don't want to do this!
You know what? I don't care! I've already got another wife anyway. You wouldn't know her.
What?
She goes to a different school! You make me feel like I'm living a teenage dream. The way you turn me on, I can't sleep. Let's run away and don't ever look back. Don't ever look back. My heart's...
In this corner, weighing in at 90 kilos, it's Jenny the Hot Butcher Reynolds! And in this corner, weighing in at a whopping 110 kilos, Timmy, the Team Mega Bronze!
Excuse me! We've talked about this. You can't keep introducing new office employees by their weight.
Sorry. Won't do it again. Can we still make them fight?
Absolutely. Survival of the fittest! We gotta fight, 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 fight for this love. We gotta fight.
Yo, it's your friend Chazza here. Thoughts on a sex education show about the romantic side of STDs? Beauty and the Yeast? Call me back! All you can do is make the best of it now. Can't be afraid of the dark. Just know that you're not in this thing alone. There's always a place in me that you can call.
Are you stressed?
Yes!
Worried about work?
Yes!
All those marks in the corner of your room that pile up and up, and you just don't have the energy to clean.
God, yes!
Well, why not try our new product? Have a break. Have an existential crisis. All of the cool kids are doing it. Why worry about schoolwork, relationships, or a mandatory third thing? When you'll inevitably face oblivion alone. Struggling to ask out your crush?
Hi, smiley face. I was just wondering if maybe you'd like to go for a drink with me. Please.
No one will ever be able to understand you in the way you find meaningful.
Oh, what's the point?
Existential crisis. Don't need to worry about that anymore. Trying to add a new skill to your CV? Of climate change?
No.
What?
Just don't believe in it, sorry.
How about you? Worried about climate change?
You think I am, yes.
Thank God for that.
Sheep.
Can't handle the strength of four fat original existential crisis? Well, why not try a new diet nihilism range? In a variety of fun flavours, from optimistic...
Ha ha! Nothing matters!
...to pessimistic...
Nothing matters!
Buy now and we'll throw in free eternal rage from the depths of hell! I need somebody, not just
anybody. You know I need someone. When I was younger, so much younger than today,
anybody's
help in
any way.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is going to be super fun.
Let's get that pacemaker out.
So come on, spin me around now.
Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbour. And commandment 10. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbour's wife.
No. Sorry, ma'am. I suppose I'll stop now. You weren't to know.
Is that all of them then, Moses?
Yeah, that's... Actually, there's one more. Commandment 11. Thou shalt not cook with mushrooms.
That's funny, you hate mushrooms.
That's all of them, so I will see you all next week for the burning bush.
Yeah. Okay. Quick question. That last one. Be weird for God to take such a stance on mushrooms like that.
Well, it is written in here, so...
Yeah, but what about Jeremy?
Who?
Jeremy. Mushroom. Jeremy. Jeremy, the mushroom merchant.
I mean, I can't sell my mushrooms anymore. I'll covet his wife, my life's a living hell.
Can you do one on aubergines? I hate aubergines.
Oh, look, commandment 12. Thou shalt not ask Moses any more questions about commandment 11.
You said that was all of them.
Well, my thumb was covering it.
I think if it's written there, we should be allowed to see it.
Yeah.
Come on, Moses.
Because when I was up there, God said that only I shall see them. So.
Come on, get them here!
Thou shalt not snap.
Come on.
Commandment 12, no more in Moses' stuff.
You've already said number 12! You're just making them up! Come here! Moses!
Oh, fuck.
You missed another one.
Right! Yeah, number 13.
I shall receive foot rubs.
And me.
And him. Him and me shall receive foot rubs whenever we want.
Thank you, big guy.
No worries, bro.
This is Beetalicious. Let's do the dino time!
Charlie!
Solar system was vast. Just wait until you hear the size of our universe. Coming soon to BBC One, a new documentary about the stars. With me, Professor Brian.
Cut! Brian, really? Some professionalism, please!
Put it down in
the... We've only got
to BBC One, a new documentary about the stars, with me, Professor Brian
Cut! Brian, really?
Oh, for f***'s sake!
Bring on the sub!
Hi, my name's Professor James Twat.
Coming!
Charlie again. Thoughts on Hole in the Berlin Wall? Celebrities contort themselves into different shapes to escape East Berlin. We would keep the shiny suits of the original, but we would add some gunfire. I have spoken to Anton Dubek, and if anything, he's a bit too keen. She clean up with her face, but I love my baby. You talking money, need a hearing aid. You talking about me, I don't see a shade.
Oh, this is so exciting. Keep coming this way.
What's that smell?
So, you remember when I asked you about your perfect dinner party?
Yes.
And I said you could have any guest you wanted. Dead or alive.
Are those corpses?
Welcome to your dream dinner party. We'll be meeting everyone. So here we have Marilyn Monroe. Say hello.
Hello.
Elvis.
Want to show off.
Who's this? Toby. Or not. Toby.
Okay.
It's William Shakespeare!
Did you rob their graves?
Of these two, yes. Elvis, turns out, was still alive. Crazy stuff. I also got you Stephen Fry.
Stephen Fry is not dead.
Was not dead. He's in the freezer.
So it was you who made my calippos.
Are you annoyed because I couldn't get you David Attenborough? Because, I mean, he's 93, you know, so if you want to do this again next year, I mean...
Absolutely not. I did not ask for any of this.
Actually, you did. And I wasn't going to mention it, but I was a bit annoyed when you were organising your little dinner party and I wasn't promoted!
Because you're insane!
Insanely good at party planning.
I'm calling the police.
You didn't tell me you wanted them! I could easily have killed Sting. Do you want a party ring?
No.
Anyone else? Bodies in the bowling tree. Bodies making chemistry. Bodies on my family. Bodies in the way of me. Bodies in the cemetery. And that's the way it's gonna be. All we've ever wanted is to look good naked. Hope that someone can take it. God's...
Yep, that is definitely a urinary tract infection. Timmy,
Unfortunately, we've been planning this for ages.
The bear didn't arrive, Mom.
What? But we ordered it weeks ago.
I know, Mom.
Did you track the delivery?
It was Royal Mail second class, Mom.
There's no tracking with second class.
Silence, man of facts. Go, log on to my eBay, find the order.
Yes, Mom.
Big Bear, is everything okay?
Everything is going exactly to plan, but man, your fate will soon be bearing down on you as we speak. Enjoy your final...
Big Bear, what's your email?
It's BigBear12XX.
At Gmail?
Hotmail.
Thank you!
I cannot bear the anticipation much.
Password?
Big boobs.
What?
I said big boobs.
It's not working.
Yeah, no, the O's are zeros.
Big buzz, zero, zero, buzz. Oh, it says the parcel's meant to arrive any minute.
Parcel's for Miss Bieber.
Yes, now, Batman. Now it's finally time for you to make your own.
Could you just get your parcel, please?
Sorry, move that with me.
Oh, nice one. Bear?
I don't get it.
Batman, can I have a selfie?
Can you leave? So, where was I? Now, Batman, now it's finally time for you to meet your grisly end! Timothy, you are fired!
I'm your teddy bear. You left me in your room. My button eyes are falling out. Pull my cotton hair. Thread needles through my skin. Am I someone or just a
Sega!
We're delighted to announce the latest addition to our beloved Sega franchise.
Get me 3 million shares in gold rings.
Sonic, the hedge fund manager.
Gotta go fast!
Gotta go fast! Gotta go fast! Gotta go fast, too fast, too
fast! Hi, darling. It's Jane from the BBC. If we agreed to call you in for a meeting, will you please promise to stop calling my house phone?
Location without any explanation. No time for relaxation. Don't wink. Don't think. Just go.
Oh no, a crime. What are we to do? Wait, what's that up there? Is this a plane? Justice!
Oh my god, it's alive!
How are you?
Greetings, citizens! It is I, Bird Plane Man! Part bird, part plane, all hero. They deserve up justice, equality, and duty free.
There's been a mugging.
Well, Bird Plane Man is here to answer the cuckoo.
I don't think you're a real superhero.
Don't be rude.
Well, name one superpower you have.
A part bird, part plane, and I can talk?
Name two superpowers you have.
He can fly.
Yes. If by flying you mean falling, it's generally a case of jumping off a building and seeing if I land at a crime scene. Today's the first time, actually. I prepared a little speech, just in case. May I?
You should probably
Thank you very much. Once a humble pigeon, I was bitten by a radioactive Airbus A380.
Okay, that's awesome.
Everyone's raving about Bird Plane Man. He's out to stop crime. Or you could say, anything ill eagle. Ha!
Like the bird.
Eagle?
I got it. Of course he's in serious danger.
Why, well, I spent ages preparing this speech. They loved it at my local open mic night. Obviously, did a bit of crowd banter as well. What do you do for a living?
Fuck off.
I suppose I better sort out this mugging then. With Bird Plane Man!
The early bird catches the criminal. Bird plane man, away! Whoosh!
Hi-ya! Wa-pow! Vulcan punch, eagle strike, couple ammo!
Everyone is dead.
You have to fire this man.
But he's so fucking cool.
Big up Headmaster!
Does that kid have a flare? That's what I go to school for. The wind is not ignored. You can call me crazy. I know that she craves me. That's what I go to school for. The wind is a real war. The winds have been plenty. The life is my kid.
Just a few more. You, sir? Ready?
Careful.
back.
There you go, sir. And again? Yeah?
Okay.
Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
I'm back.
When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. And if a get an attitude, pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Sean Don and I'm over best, cause I got it going on. I'm a nice dude.
I strike the goblin with my enchanted sword.
13 damage. It's dead. The village is saved.
Hey, honey. Oh, it started without me. I'll have to catch up with you boys.
Just join in. You'll pick it up as we go along.
Don't worry, babe. I'm very experienced in roleplay.
Okay, great. Well, there's a spare wizard troll you can use.
He's pretty big.
A big troll. My favourite.
Massive.
Well, he's actually average height for a member of the troll race.
Oh, pedantry. You do know what I like, don't you?
I don't know.
What's going to happen next?
Well, the party has just reached the heart of Goblin Mountain, and we're about to find out why the village's dogs have been going missing.
It's because they're being sold to the nomadic werewolves as slaves. Sexy slaves! Oh yeah!
Are you two all right?
Yeah, honey, I'm just getting into it. You're doing a really good job.
Yeah, man, this is so much better than I thought it would be.
Okay, well, let's carry on. You enter the goblin headquarters, and the whole place reeks of dog shit.
Oh, yes!
Derek, why is your hand on my leg?
Just go with it, man.
Phil, what's wrong? I thought that's what you wanted.
But what was what I wanted?
You made a group chat called Roleplay with an aubergine emoji.
I've come to Moussaka! What did you think Derek was doing here?
I thought I might have wanted a menage a trois situation. You're in a bed.
With my brother Derek! Dezza, what did you think was going on?
Orgy, to put it bluntly.
So, hang on. You're not turned on by goblins?
Don't be ashamed, man. I mean, I wouldn't have admitted it before, but I do always get a semi in home base when I walk past the gnomes.
Fuck off! I'm leaving! This is sick!
Phil!
I'm so sorry.
That's all right.
This is really embarrassing.
Shall I unzip the elf lady's trousers?
Yes.
The goblin girl from the mystery world. The goblin girl from the mystery world.
Trick
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 the goblin girl.
Make me weep.
So, that's the show.
And I think we completed all of our unfinished business.
Title of the show again.
Yeah.
I finally watched Mrs. Brown's Boys. I got my commission.
I did my beatboxing.
And it was sick. Winky winky.
Wait, where's Lydia?
Hi, Mum, it's me. How are you doing?
Fuck off, Lydia.
How'd it go?
Well, she's speaking to me again.
Nice! There we go!
So, what happens now?
Do we all get beamed up into heaven or something?
Oh, we don't have the budget for that.
Why is nothing happening?
You guys all got your eternal rest confirmation emails, right?
Yeah. Of course.
Daisy.
I don't understand. I completed my unfinished business. All I had to do was do a show with my best friends in the entire world.
No.
What?
It's just, we see you more as just a colleague.
What an emotional roller coaster.
Now's not the time.
I mean, we could perform one last sketch, you know, for Daisy.
Yeah.
suffer the torturous limbo-like existence of haunting a student theatre in Durham?
Yes!
Yeah. Go on then. One last sketch with my best friend. Colleagues.
And here we go!
Go on, then!
Oh,
50
pence a try, boys!
Oh, here you go!
Perfect, are you ready?
Oh, I think so!
Well, let the games commence!
Do I not need, like, a mallet or something?
If I told you you were ugly, how would you react? So,
why is the machine talking?
Well, either you're fucking ugly.
Look, I thought you were testing my strength!
Nah. The physical strength stand is over there! We test your emotional strength, sir! You have the torso to leg ratio of a sausage dog.
Jesus!
You will form meaningful and loving relationships.
Oh, that one's quite nice.
Sometimes she glitches. Give her a kick.
Oh.
You will die alone.
What? I didn't sign up for any of this. I want my 50p back.
On to level two. We've got your kids.
What? Oh my God, my children!
To shoot one of them. Who is your least favourite?
Come on, boy!
Come on, you choose!
Timmy or Eric? Who will it be?
No!
You've got to choose, mate!
I can't!
You have to choose!
No! Timmy! Shoot Timmy!
Shoot Eric.
My poor boy! My poor favourite son!
You scored a respectable 6 out of 10. You can pick any prize from the middle shelf.
Oh, I'll take the toy minion. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for one last time for the Durham Revue!
Like I never told ya. Never. Don't act like I never told ya. 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 Baby, you're making it all up.
Better, faster, stronger.
That don't kill me. Can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up now. Can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right now. Cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night now. That's how long I've been on ya.